That's fucking perfect. That's exactly what I want.
Thank you.
where I want to be. Pick me up and turn me round. I feel numb. Born with all we got, I guess that means I'm having fun. I can't tell one from another. Make it up as we go along. Feet on the ground, head in the sky. It's okay, I know nothing's wrong. Nothing's ill. Got plenty of time. Oh, in your eyes. And you're standing here beside me. I love the passing of time. Never for money, always for love. Cover up and say goodnight. Say goodnight. Is where I want to be, but I guess I'm already there. I come home, she lifted up her wings. I guess that this must be the place. I can tell one from another. Did I find you or you find me? There was a time before we were born. If someone asks, this is where I'll be, where I'll be. Oh, we lifted it out. Oh, sing into my mouth. And out of all those kinds of people, you've got a face with a view. I'm just an animal looking for a soul, man. Share the same space for a minute or two. And you love me till my heart stops. Love me till I'm dead. As I'm lit up, I see through you. Cover up the flame spots, hit me on the head. I go,
bang. There's a little creep down here. I mean, just fucking look at it. Very liminal. Quite a liminal space, you'd say.
Thank you.
Concert go. Again, being looking at my daughter, going, don't want to live no more. Can you see that it's late at night? I'm very tired and I'm not feeling right. I choose to be alone. Going, don't you invade my home. Best up that you hang outside. Going, oh, so running high, who can it be now? 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 people are taking their morning showers. I'll be honest, I do feel uncomfortable putting my back to things. We all feel comfortable over here, buddy. But I don't know what's in store to go through. Well, the door's locked, so. Should be safe. But now, standing here, I don't know what's past that wall. That's why I like the corner you're in, because you can see everything except what's behind you, but there's a blind. So no one can see. Say that creativity is set and bound by limitations. I would agree. I'll explain to you what I mean. This is my instrument, melodica. Last key doesn't work. Maybe show not tell is better, but I showed you and then I told you. Maybe I'm questioning your intelligence. I mean, does not that demonstrate it by going? Keys. Does it say 32 on here? What does it say on here? Really not that much. It does say fa sol la si do re mi fa sol la ti do re mi fa sol la si do and then 1 7 5 6 4 3 2 1 7 6 5 4 3 2 1 7 6. So you see, no branding on it. I quite like that. I wonder if I can. Oh no. Oh. Yeah, this is an unstable table. Especially for someone of my weight. By a woman who has a YouTube channel, Contra Points, a video called Darkness. We got about 4 minutes into the video. I'd already watched about 2 hours, maybe more so, of her content. Came down here, started doing this. Tell you more about that later. can't play every note. I only have 31 notes, technically. This is an extra feature. I guess for my own applause. Sounds kind of like applause, never noticed that. But I do think limitations beget creativity.
She leaves baby back ribs. 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 I want my baby back ribs.
I can't get that note. He's creative, but I can't get that note. It's like, this can't.
I want my baby back.
You have to shoot the key. Closing your eyes is scarier than putting a band over your head. Take a look at these hands. Take a look at these hands. Hands of a government man. And then he goes on, 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 and then he goes on. Take a look at these hands. Take a look at these hands. hands of Government Man. I'll get these later. Fuck this. Shit. Fuck. Fuck. Shit. Fuck. Shit. Fuck this. Fuck. Fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Holy fuck, fuck. Look at this paint. Can't seem to face up to the facts. I'm tense and nervous and I can't relax. Don't touch me, I will realize why. Don't touch me, I realize why. Can't sleep because my bed's on fire. Far better. Run, 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 run. Far better. Run, 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 run away.
Picture, picture, picture. Picture, picture, picture this. Picture, picture, picture.
5 seconds, or maybe 40. Caution. Do not place toe warmer directly against skin. That's the moral of the story. If you're looking for one. Oh, hey. That's actually kind of useful. I might take a steal of that later. There's a whiteboard. Over there. I don't think you can see. We have one up on the third floor. Nothing's stopping you from moving all this furniture. Stopping me at all. I should be making note cards in the past 2 days. Now we have 2 days to study. But that's okay. So I think it's a sign. Oh, look who it is. Oh, well, this is your silica gel. This is the largest packet of silica gel I've ever seen. Makes a good sound when you crush it around in your hands. It smells kind of like sugar. Listen. Would you like to take a survey? Would you like to take a questionnaire? I have a couple questions that I'd like to ask you. Would you eat a packet of silica gel? I wonder what it tastes like. There's nothing, but it sticks in your mouth. Kind of pops a little bit, like pop rocks. Yes, it is. Observing moisture. Now, a couple questions. If you wouldn't mind. How do you feel? Have you enjoyed your stay? Would you come again? Can you come again? Can you describe in detail in a paragraph or two or more how you feel? That's a bad question. I have a better one. How do you perceive me? What do you think of my music? That question has two parts. What do you think of my melodical playing? Should have asked that. I should have asked the question, what do you think about my melodica playing? Then what do you think of my singing? What do you think of my speaking? What do you think about my movement? Because I think these are four parts to whatever this is. That's what's come. I guess the fifth part is, what do you think about the stage? That's a rough word, but I mean, this scenery, this place. I think I'm too fat. I think I'm way too fat. I can't stop eating, I don't like moving. What's the worst thing you've ever done? Do you wonder if you've ever done anything that's worse than that without knowing? Your action directly caused suffering of others in a preventable way. Does that even matter? Would you be responsible? Does it have to do with intent? Does it? What does it have to do with intent? Do you believe in God? Why and why not? Your answers in the comments down below. What do you think will happen when I push this watering fountain? Do you think any liquid will come out? Put your answers down below. Okay. Let's see if you were right. Do you prefer straight lines or curvy lines? Is there a difference between introverts? No, let me rephrase that. Are introverts and extroverts real? Or are we all a mix of the two? If you do extrovert things alone in the room, no one's here watching me. So I'm an introvert. But I'm posting these all on my public YouTube channel. So it's as if I've done all these things in public. Is there a difference? I guess it is different. Singing in front of a stage versus singing in front of a camera. You're not singing in front of the stage, you're singing in front of a crowd. Crowds tend to gather around stages. Ridiculous for stages to gather around crowds. That's the puddle. Fallacy. What is this? Made into a flower. I made it out of a wire from a disposable face mask. And we look for America. Look for America. Look for America. Look for America. I light the fire and you can. plant flowers and the earth where we born today. Stand by fire for hours and hours and the earth we say. Our house is a very, very, very fine house with two cats in the yard. Life used to be so hard. Now everything is easy 'cause of you. Ben, now, na 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 na. It's a very, very, very fine house to get in. Yeah. Life used to be so hard. Now everything is easy 'cause of you. Just like you're on the road, must have a coat that can live by, and so become yourself, because the past is just a goodbye. Teach children well, fathers help. Don't you have some? If you ever asked them why, they'd say that you would cry. You just look at them and sigh, and know they love you,
and know they love you,
and know they love you. Don't you ask them why, as he would cry. Just look at him and sigh, and know he loves you. And it's slowly gonna die, and so drifting through the shadows, lines of the evening, as we gather by me, as we
thank you. I'll be so serious. I'll be so serious. I'll be so serious. I'll be so serious.
About 10 minutes. Ugh. 10 minutes to 90 minutes. It's been 80 minutes. Have you enjoyed the show? Have you? I have. This has been so much fucking fun. That's the point where you notice you lost a piece of I'll tell you later.
What I was gonna say was that whenever you create a piece of art, you put your soul into it. If you do it right, you put your soul in it, and a piece of you is put into that work of art. I've put a lot of my soul in this work. It's very genuine, I think. Captures a good slice. Because any painting is kind of a self-portrait if you think about it. It's probably artsy bullshit. Maybe that's my, reflection away from sincerity. Because if you say things in jest, then people won't hold you accountable for your ideas. But if you say things seriously, as if you actually believe them, well, then you have to really hold on to those things that you say. If you say things that you actually mean, you believe, but are controversial, you think they're right, but people won't see it that way. If you say them, you'll get flack. Because for some reason, being serious, being genuine, being kind, being empathetic is weak? Bad? That's what the quote that Gandalf says to Bilbo in their courage, Bilbo. It's not about I'm going to take a life, I'm going to spare it. And so on and so forth. Pib Extra. Spicy cherry soda. I have something else that's funny to say. Here it is. I'm exactly where you are right now. I'm watching the screen. I'm behind the screen. I'm looking at it. I'm watching the same thing that you are, really. How meta. We're literally sitting in the same spot, looking at the same thing right now. That's what I like about the fisheye lens. You can really, gives a better perspective of actual field of view and actual vision. So I can more accurately capture what I see. Why I chose this place and this angle. Well, I liked it. I sat here first. I was like, wow, this is quite a striking scene. It's liminal. It's very liminal. So, why not spend some time in the liminal space? It's contradictory by nature of it, you know? That's what makes it interesting, that's what gives it its spark, I think. I wonder if you understand what I'm saying. Who knows? morning now. I can see the sky. Turn blue and the snow below it, and also turning blue. I like the snow. It's my favorite element. I feel like it's my element, you know. Some people are earth, other people are water, other people are ice. I'm snow. I remember after biking one day, I hugged my mother in the kitchen, and she said I smelled like snow. Smelled pure like snow, I think. Of course, the reason was that, you know, it was the fresh air. I've been biking. I like the snow. It's so beautiful. It's the uniformity. I like it. It's very textural, you know. You can crunch it in your hand. There are different types of snow. Gives it variety, keeps it interesting. So though, even though it's uniform, it's changing. Interesting. Birds are awake, I can hear it chirping. I hit my hand on the snow to scoop some up. I don't like looking at myself in the mirror because I don't like my body very much. It's rather uncharitable, isn't it, I suppose? Maybe I should get back in frame, but I'm quite comfortable where I am sitting now, honestly. This next chair is really comfy. Oh, blast. I think I'm out of music. I could try. Maybe. I put up to my mouth, it's not. Oh yeah, I think I'm out. I'm out of music. No. It's quite bright out now. The sun is really rising. For you. It's really quite nice. Well, there's a car. You know, let me tell you. Hasn't. There. Must have tilted when I wasn't looking. I was gonna say that I like documenting this. This is very intimate and shows you what I'm really like. This is the whiteboard I was talking about. Oh, controls wonderfully. Oh.
Whiteboard, thinking about bringing up into the common area. I think I will. If I want to come down and dance with it, I can just take it with me. So, as I was saying, whether I look at my YouTube channel, it's kind of like a time capsule. When I look back and see what it was like, I guess that's kind of a, selfish, egotistical reason to document me. I hear a beeping. Well, it's just a bird. I'm afraid that someone will come down the elevator and watch me. I'll leave. Well, first of all, I'm going to put on my mask and then I'll wave awkwardly or something. And I ask what you're doing. I'm like, oh, I don't know what I should say if they ask me what I was doing. But if they're here, they're just probably trying to get on their way. This area really is a liminal space, you know. Liminal means transitional. Think about an airport hangar, a parking lot. These are spaces that aren't necessarily meant to be, you know, lived in. maybe. They're just places that you're supposed to stay for a little while and then leave. A lot of times whenever they're empty, without human life, seem very strange. Ironically, since you're watching me, this place might seem rather comfortable. After all, you have spent about 2 hours in this space watching me move and sing and talk and run. So it's very natural. This place is a bit devoid of context, so whatever happens in here is kind of naturally occurring. This is a basement of a dorm room building. I live on the third floor. This is the basement. And so, the way that it's liminal is that people enter in that door, go on the elevator, and then go up their rooms, or go from their rooms down and out that door to go to class or to the cafeteria to get food. And sometimes once they get their food, they come back, walk through these doors just to go back up into their rooms. The cafeteria and the room, those are the destinations. This is just the place that's walked between point A and point B. Also, there's a storage room. Literally, there's storage. I don't know what that is. I don't know if those are storage. There are lots of tables and chairs and whiteboards being stored down here. There are tables with chairs with no one sitting in them. So, if you look at a table and a chair with no one sitting in it, it becomes kind of a strange thing. Not to mention the yellow bins everywhere. That's what makes it extra liminal, because these yellow bins are for transporting people's things to and from places. Mostly they're for moving in and moving out of college campuses. You have one, take it to your car, put all your stuff in it, and then cart it to your dorm room. And then take it back. This is where they're stored. Not all of them. I don't think anyway. Or maybe it is. I don't think so. I mean, pretty confident other buildings have other ones. So, they're liminal devices meant for transition to move things from one place to another. Liminal boxes in a liminal space. That's why this is, said the word lots of times. But my YouTube channel is for documenting me. Hi. I've been very much myself in this space. I don't know if you can tell. We're so used to putting on shows and performances to interact with society. I play the role of the student. I play the role of the person studying. as well as the person watching videos. Acting on stage, but here I'm alone. By myself. Can you see that? Are you bored? I would be. God, I couldn't imagine sitting through and watching all of this. I don't think I've been nearly entertaining enough. I highly doubt that anyone would actually go and sit through and watch all of this. I'm going to upload it. Don't take quite some time at this campus internet. Seems to be quite bad about uploading things. Quite slow upload speed. Download speed is fine. I guess that is a smart way to prioritize things. I don't know. Oh yeah, this channel. This video is documenting me and what I'm like. What I think and what I do, what I draw, what I say, the music I make. And things. I like that. And I can look back and be like, hey, I wonder what I was like in college. This is what I'm like. I think this is exactly what I'm like. This video. Who am I, or who was I now? I am me now. Hi. I was quite a different person before, but not really. I mean, you can still see the similarities and differences. I'm still me. My essence. Philosophers are different words for it. My soul. I like that one. Then you get into metaphysics, which suck. Compared to science, I don't mind studying them and learning about them, but good God, they're just... There's a drought of metaphysical answers. That's why it sucks. It's not as clear and dry as science. Oh, but then you look, that's also like a science. Oh, fuck. Not clear and dry at all. And there are so many things and questions. Maybe I don't know. I've not explored it myself. I've just been told there's lots of things we don't know about. And of course, because I don't know everything. It's, where do you start? Where do you go? You have to study. I don't want to go down that rabbit hole. I'm just. Because you can't know everything. Or maybe you can. But it just takes a while. I mean, look at Bill Gates. He reads a lot of stuff and seems to know about a lot and invests and lots of things. I don't think I'll be a billionaire, though. Maybe that's a self-defeating mindset. I think it is a level of mindset, but and you do need it to get to that level. It's not going to happen without me putting considerable effort. That's the problem. Even if I put in considerable effort, there are no guarantees. There are no guarantees. I made a piece of artwork that's called There Are No Guarantees. It's crayon. Orange and yellow and red. I don't think any red, just different oranges and yellows. It says there are no guarantees. I show you a picture. Maybe I'll show. I think it's on my Instagram somewhere. Probably with frog in art. I could be wrong. Thereabouts, maybe. But there are no guarantees. Which. I don't know how to feel about that. Because people say I guess it's life isn't beautiful because it lasts. I guess that's true. It's not beautiful because it lasts. It's beautiful because it's beautiful. And something that's beautiful for a moment versus something that's beautiful for 1,000 years. Well, I mean, both exist in the mind. I've seen the statue of David. I've also seen Snowfall. Both are beautiful. Snowfall, I think, is more beautiful. Statue of David is the best framed work of art of all time. The fucking framing is masterful. Because, you know, they have a replica of it standing outside the Medici's castle. And you look at it and you fucking walk by. It doesn't stand it at all. You're like, oh, there it is. Another bronze replica. And you can say that, oh, you know, of course it's not as beautiful as a replica. I'd say bullshit. I'd say the reason the Statue of David is so impressive. Yeah, it is an impressive statue, but I think it's made more so because of the framing. The building itself, you know? You walk in, you walk through some other hallways, and it's generally pretty dark. And all the other artwork they have in the building in Florence, all the other artwork is this shitty fucking medieval Christian engraving. You know, all just, you know, shitty 2D. It's so flat. It's so flat and boring. Made of wood with gold etching and things. God, it's just so. And it's like rooms full of this stuff. And it's all the fucking same. I mean, of course there's differences, but it's so. It's just so bad. It's like you look at how people could paint realistically. And then you're like, what the fuck happened? Why couldn't you do this? Like, why couldn't you do this? Is it, like, the study of light really that important? It looks like it. Probably. Fucking hell. Peace and perspective. And so, we have all this shitty art. The rest of the museum full of shit art. In the piggy, you know, and So that's what you're framed with. You're framed and you're primed with all this shitty 2D flat Christian art. Dull colors. What have you. And also the place is very dark. Quite dark. Kind of like that wall. Yeah. But then you take a turn. You take a turn. And you're looking down this long hallway. It's like multiple chambers that go to the main chamber and then the rotundrum that David is held in. All right, and so you walk down, the main hallway is what's really dark. So like you go down this dark hallway, and then David is towering above you, bathed in white light with the pillars and columns behind him. It's just the perfect fucking thing. It's just the perfect framing. Most beautiful fucking framing in the world that accentuates the beauty of the statue. So it's such an imposing statue. And that's the dilemma, because I've seen the replicas and the verses standing there in front of the thing. That's why I think, hey, it's the staging that's doing a lot of the work to really make it, with the dome and the light and the pillars and the whiteness, and then just him standing there. And there's nothing else there but him, and all the other art is shit, and so then it's there, and it's like, wow, that's really a lot better than all this other shit art. And it does well on its own, like you put it next to the Mona Lisa, all these other classical famous artwork. I saw the Mona Lisa too, quite nice, I got quite close to it, probably closer, about the distance from me to where you are. It was fine. I like the pictures of a bowl of fruit that was there. And the Louvre. God, the fucking Louvre. Oh! In retrospect, next time I go, I'll spend more time not in the Egyptian section. I spent a lot of time in the Egyptian section with my friend Ben, because my dad did that when he was my age. He said, when I was your age, you know, the whole place was crowded, but in the basement, all these pristine artifacts from Egypt, and no one was there. And I was like, holy shit. And I did that because my dad did that, and that's very, very special and touching to me. That I did the same thing with my friend, the same age. I love my dad so much. But, you know, I think I'd rather spend more time admiring all the other cooler artwork than all the Egyptian shit that the friend stole. So it's good for the sentiment, but the quality of the artwork down there, too par. I can't understand why, you know, people don't go down there. France, Paris, Paris. Fucking Paris, what a fucking city. Good God. Oh, that is such an insane, man. I'd go back right now. I had a dream I'd go back. Let me tell you, Eiffel Tower is fucking massive. Oh my God, the Eiffel Tower is huge. One of the, well, probably, I don't know if it's the biggest, probably the biggest building I've seen in my life. Stood underneath it. Oh, God. Wonderful. So wonderful. That trip. Collectively, second best experience of my life. And you know, if I think about it, I think overall, collectively, yeah, it is better. No, jet skiing in Emerald Bay is still the best. Jet skiing in Emerald Bay really is the best. The Europe trip, holy fuck. Oh. God. Yeah, it's that's really interesting because went and saw the Europe notification. Wonder what that is. Probably weather. Saw Europe. And then to see Europe get locked down because of COVID, it's like, holy shit, wow. It's like I really got to experience what it was like over there right before the pandemic, you know? And that made seeing all the city squares and everything empty a lot more jarring than I think it would to a lot of other Americans who hadn't been there. Now I'm here. Quite nice. Grass is always greener on the other side, of course. Life is a sine wave, I'm gonna ride it all night long. I said, life is a sine wave, I'm gonna ride it all night long. Ooh, life is a sine wave, and I'm gonna ride it all. Sine wave, I'm gonna ride it on a
guess I must be having fun. So say it better, make it up as we go along. Feet on the ground, head in the sky. It's okay, I know nothing's wrong. Nothing's wrong.
Oh.
Look at this painting.
I didn't make it, I don't know who made it. I think it's beautiful. Take it. I hope others will enjoy it. That's why I'm making it. But this is a liminal space, so they'll probably just pass on by without giving you a second call.
Thank you.
That's weird. That's a fucking. That's bizarre. Oh well. Oh, my hair. I need a shower. Anyway, I think it's
time to wrap things up, okay? I know. You're gonna miss me. Don't worry. You know, I could say, don't worry, I'll be back, but the reality is, there are no guarantees. I'd like to make more videos, but there's a chance that I won't be able to. There are no guarantees. I could die. Go to hell. Where I belong. Or YouTube could just delete my channel. Did that before. Meaning to make a backup of all my videos. I was too lazy to. There's so many. I don't have that big of an ego. Well, I hope you've had fun. And I know it's going to be hard. It's going to be hard for me too. But it gets easier as time passes. Day by day. Week by week, month by month, year by year. I promise it gets easier. It gets better even, I'd say. That's my experience anyway. But, yeah. Plus, hey, always just watch this again from the top. Could. If you feel like it, you know. I won't be deleting it. Well, maybe I will. So, you can save it. Put it on a flash drive, just on your desktop. ytmp3.com. Downloads as MP4 too. Oh no, but that doesn't download. I think they have an hour limit. Oh damn. Sucks. Screen record the whole thing. Could do that. Screen record the whole thing. Watch the whole thing again. So that's a thing you could do. Jeez Louise. Now look. Let's be honest. I don't know if anyone's gonna watch these. I mean, this especially. I mentioned this earlier, but like, well, I don't know. I mean, I don't think I've been that entertaining. I mean, in some ways, yeah, maybe I do. Like, I don't even know what to brand this. I think it'll have a catchy thumbnail, catchy title. Something like, oh, what would be a good title for this video. I think that would be a good one. Just the liminal space, maybe? Concert in liminal space.
mask just in case. How do I look? Okay. See, I told you it was a liminal space. Just walking to and fro. What was I saying? One thing or the other. Concert, I mean, this is not a concert. I want it to be simple. Maybe in the description will describe more of what I think this is. Yeah, the description for this, I think, will be quite important. Just describe what this experience is. That's quite the experience. You know, concert. What is like what plays in the to the back rooms? A concert in the back rooms, yeah. I mean, this place doesn't exactly fit the description, but it's close enough, you know. Back rooms concert. Yeah, back rooms, I like back rooms concert. That's simpler. Hashtag liminal. Oh, but I feel that's a bit clickbaity, but I mean, not really. I mean, you can take this. It's, I mean, there's no shag carpet. Still strange. Basement. It's a basement, isn't it? Well, the sign says anyway. Basement concert. Concert implies music. This has been mostly music, I'd say. Singing and dancing and